Sleep is an absolutely key component of our wellness and our ability to perform and stay awake. We don't really know what sleep does, except that we know it's very important for recovery and recovery of brain function. So anything that involves brain function, like your ability to perform during the day, your ability to stay awake, is impacted by sleep. There are two main factors that affect how well we can sleep at night. First of all, there's a system which measures how long you've been awake, and so you have to have been awake for a reasonable amount of time before you can fall asleep. The other system that controls your sleep is your circadian clock, your daily cycle, and humans have been set up to sleep at night and be active in the day. And so first of all, you want to keep a very structured sleep-wake schedule as much as possible to try and do the same thing every day, because that will help the circadian system to make sure you sleep at the right time. Other things that affect your sleep, which you need to control, are things like light exposure. Bright light before bed or light from electronic devices will keep you alert. And so you need to try and avoid bright light and have a dimmer, redder light in the evening before sleep. Also, caffeine is something which often keeps us awake if we drink it too late in the day. And so try and stop caffeine use after lunchtime. And then doing things which are relaxing in the evening can help with sleep. Many of us are very active right up until we go to bed, and so we're worrying about things when we sleep. And so if you can do something to split the day from the night, which could be breathing exercises, meditation, yoga, a hot bath, a warm non-caffeinated drink, listening to music, something that you find relaxing will help split the day from the night and help the brain relax and fall asleep quicker. People often want to know, how much sleep do I need? And usually so they can work out how little they can get away with. And that's the wrong attitude with sleep. You need to have enough sleep for you and your brain recovery. And most of us understand how well we do on certain levels of sleep. On average, it's recommended that adults get 7 or more hours a night, every night. And that, of course, is much higher in teenagers, which can be 9 or 10 hours a night or more, and even more in children who need much more sleep than that. And so we should all be aiming for at least 7 and more than that, ideally, each night. But a key thing with sleep is to try and plan ahead. If you know that you're going to be sleep deprived, if you have a deadline you have to meet, try and sleep a little more before that to try and build up a little bit of sleep reserve. Or if you then have been awake for a long time, try and recover adequately to make sure you get enough sleep afterwards. And so try and get the right amount of sleep every night for you, but also make sure that you try and bank a little bit of sleep when you can, or recover if you've had times when you've not been able to sleep. So jet lag is caused by us shifting our sleep-wake and light-dark cycle too quick for the body clock to keep up with. We are able to change by minutes a day. For example, now in Finland, we can react to that change in the sunset and sunrise, but we can't react to changes of an hour or 2 or 3 hours a day that the brain can't keep up. And shift work is a very similar problem. If you work at night and sleep in the day, that's the equivalent of a 12-hour shift in time zone. So what you have to do is, first of all, think, well, which direction am I traveling in order to know how to adapt? And so when you're traveling westward, you need to delay the clock later. And when you travel eastward, you need to advance the clock earlier. And so while there aren't one-size-fits-all solutions, certainly if you're traveling westward before you go to bed later than normal, see light later in the evening, and start to shift your clock later. And if you're traveling in an easterly direction, go to bed earlier a few nights before you leave, see morning light, and start to shift yourself onto the new time. The problem comes often when you get to the new time zone. Sometimes you should see light, sometimes you shouldn't, and I can't give you a simple rule that tells you what to do every time. But with the Hintsa program, we put together jet lag plans for our Formula One drivers, our executives, to know when to see light, when to avoid light, how to use caffeine, how to use meal times, and so on, to make sure that they can adapt as quickly as they can. And if they do the plan, we can shift the clock by about 3 hours a day, whereas it would only shift by about an hour a day if you just did your own thing. My advice to try and help performance is to prioritize sleep. And that sounds very broad and oversimplistic, but our society hasn't valued sleep enough until very recently. We often think we have to burn the candle at both ends to achieve in life, and so sleep is often the thing that gets missed if we have to work hard or work longer. And so rethinking your attitudes to sleep and prioritizing sleep and making it a central part of your own health and wellness program is absolutely key. And if you do that, your family will do that, your colleagues will do that. People need to change their attitudes to sleep. We can't have this old attitude that 4 hours a night is good and we can sleep when we're dead and sleep is for the weak. This is all wrong. We need to reverse that attitude. And so the very simple piece of advice is to prioritize sleep.